Well, good morning, good evening, and good night, guys. Again, this is Ty the Blockbuster Guy. I wasn't going to make a video today, but I decided to go for it. Just because it's just a great hobby, honestly. It's kills a couple hours, and, well, the pandemic isn't quite over yet, so I'm still just trying to kill time each day. But yeah, today I am going to talk top 10 favorite Kevin Smith movies. I was talking about this the other day, actually, and thought, you know what, let's do a top 10 Kevin Smith. And it's going to include more than just a few obscure stuff like Mallrats and Dogma. It's going to encompass his entire career as a director. Kevin Smith is the man. I'm a big fan of Kevin Smith. I like a lot of his movies, and I like the fact that he supports a lot of Canadian stuff as well. So, you know, let's do a top 10 favorite Kevin Smith movies. So, once again, doing 10 through 1. So today I'm going to start out with number 10. One of his more notorious movies, if you've watched I guess it could be called Stand Up. It's One Night with Kevin Smith. Basically, he just talks about shit. Cop Out. He worked with Bruce Willis on this one. And, notoriously, Bruce Willis was hard to work with Kevin Smith, because Kevin Smith, I think he just used to work with his buddies, and Bruce Willis is more of an actor, like a famous actor type guy that is Bruce Willis, and apparently was really hard to work with. He's kind of an asshole, apparently. And Kevin Smith has run through the mud, actually, many, many times on his One Night with Kevin Smith. And I think they've made up ever since, but I hear that he was hard to work with. Tracy Morgan's in that as well. And Tracy Morgan, his story's kind of crazy too, actually. He was hit by, like, a Walmart truck. Like, almost killed. You know, like, messed with his head. Like, he's back, but he's still, you know, I think he got a massive settlement as well. Tracy Morgan's funny. I've always kind of liked him. But yeah, moving on. Once again, moving on to, I believe this is a Kevin Smith movie, which is kind of weird because it's like a collaboration between Seth Rogen and Kevin Smith. Zack and Miri Make a Porno. Excellent. Very funny movie. Very funny movie. It's very easy to forget that Kevin Smith directed this. Very, very easy. Just because Kevin Smith, it seems more like a Seth Rogen, almost a Judd Apatow type of thing. Here's my notebook. I got wrote down all my top tens. But yeah, Zack and Miri Make a Porno, just so funny. There's a couple scenes that I actually laugh out loud, hilarious. But it's a little long-winded though as well, so that's why it's a little lower on my. And I don't like the girl woman in it, Elizabeth Banks. Really. So what about Elizabeth Banks that really gets under my skin? I don't know why. But Seth Rogen's always funny. You know, Seth Rogen makes me laugh. Fellow Canadian boy. But yeah, moving on to number 8. Chasing Amy. Great movie, but it's a little lower on my list because it's alright. You know, it's funny. It's got Jason Lee in it, and Ben Affleck, and the whole VSQ crew. But it's kind of meh. It isn't as funny as his other ones. But yeah, I still enjoy it. I watch it from time to time, but I don't watch it as much as his top tier ones that are like higher up here. So yeah, Chasing Amy, number 8. And moving on to number 7, Tusk. Honestly, I really enjoyed it. It's cool that it takes place in like Winnipeg, close to Winnipeg. I don't know if it was filmed there, but that's where it takes place. I enjoyed it. It's a weird little movie. I find it enjoyable though. It's one of those weird ones that you kind of show to somebody and be like, what the hell am I watching? Especially by the end. Jocko Tusk though, it's definitely worth a watch. Just so you can say that you've seen it, especially if you like Kevin Smith. And Kevin Smith, cute. Number 6 is another weird one. Red State. Red State was a very strange one. Yeah, it's freaking religious people, cultish people. They piss me off. they boycotted the crap out of this movie too, as well, like they did with other his other movies. Like, I can't remember exactly what the one religious cult is called, but they're annoying. I have to look it up. Like I said, I don't do my all my due diligence with these top tens, but yeah, Red State number 6. It's almost based on a true story. I watched the actual movie about that cult that got destroyed by the ATF. South Park parodied as well, with like the negotiator. I think it was called the negotiator. It was like a giant tank. Yeah, and now we're moving into the top 5. I actually got Clerks 2 as my number 5. Yeah, I kind of did a toss-up. I wasn't sure if I was going to go Clerks or Clerks 2. As you can tell, a spoiler for number 4, but Clerks 2 is great. It's got all the Clerks guys in it. It's got Jay and Silent Bob. Jason Mewes actually got clean for this role, and you can definitely tell that he got clean. Because Jason Mewes was in, he was in a rough patch there for a while. You could see it. You could see it. And once again, One Night with Kevin Smith, he goes into detail about how Jason Mewes was, he was a mess during the filming of a lot of his movies, would massively had Jay and Silent Bob in it. You could see it. You could see it in Jason Mewes' eyes that he was on something, to say the least. To say the least. But in Clerks 2, they kind of they talk about it, about how he found God, and blah blah blah. But yeah, now Jason Mewes is doing alright. You can see it. He streams on Twitch. He actually directed a movie, which was good too. Actually, I've enjoyed it. I like Jason Mewes. It's Madness in the Method. Instead of Method in the Madness. Yeah. I enjoyed, well, Clerks too. Enjoyed it. Found it extremely funny. But Clerks basically started it all. So I gotta go number 4. Clerks. Not even supposed to be here today. I love Clerks. It's a funny story about how we got it made too as well. Very inspiring for filmmakers. If you don't know how we got Clerks made, go check it out. I think there's like documentaries and stuff like that on YouTube and different places that talk about Kevin Smith, about how he actually got Clerks made. It was extremely low budget. Very entertaining movie though. People are still finding Clerks. They're still finding a lot of Kevin Smith movies. Like, wow, that was actually really funny. And Clerks is just well written. Because Kevin Smith is he inspired me too for my screenplay. You can see a lot of Kevin Smith in my screenplay if I ever get it made, hopefully. 419, The Longest Minute. Oh yeah, I'm gonna try to sell that screenplay. But yeah, so Clerks number 4. Like I was saying, I'm not even supposed to be here today. Which I wasn't even gonna make a video today because I was blah blah blah. I was looking at other stuff and I was doing research to how to react. So I'm gonna be doing a reaction video as well very very soon. You just wait for that to come. But now moving on to number 3, my favorite Kevin Smith movies: Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back. I saw this one in theaters. Really, really enjoyed it. Actually, I've watched it many, many times. It's very, very quotable as well. Mark Hamill's great in it. There's so much to talk about Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back. The orangutan scene. Even did the reboot as well. That should have been on here, but I was only doing 10. But the reboot was only alright. Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back was absolutely fantastic, though. It's really funny. Once again, if you haven't seen any of these movies, go check them out. Kevin Smith is worth a watch. He's worth a watch. Worth a watch, eh? Hey, bud. I'm trying to let my Canadian accent come out of you. Gonna go play for a rip. Yeah. Well, I'm moving on to number 2 then. After Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, Dogma. Honestly, Dogma, I've seen many, many times. And I'm not a very religious person, as a lot of people know about me. I don't really believe in organized religion, so I watch this movie and I'm like, oh, that was so blasphemous. That was hilarious. George Carlin's great in it as well. George Carlin's great in it. Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back as well. Rest in peace, George Carlin, one of my favorite comedians of all time. Dogma with Ben Affleck and Matt Damon. Yeah, I'll just say I like Trip Parker, Matt Stone. I'm going to probably do a list of that. But that being said, Dogma is great. Go check it out. It's got Alan Rickman in it, too, as well. Once again, rest in peace, Alan Rickman. Got one of the greatest voices of all time, too, as well. And he's also a great villain. It just Alan Rickman's got that voice to be a villain. He's also Die Hard. He's in Harry Potter, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, check out, you know, everybody knows Alan Rickman. Some people don't know names, but they look at it. I'm like, oh, that's Alan Rickman. But yeah. Number one, I've seen this movie so many times too as well. Mallrats. Chocolate covered pretzel. If you've seen it, you know. The movie's just so funny. Plus, Michael Rooker's in it. I'm a big Rook fan. Michael Rooker's great. He's great in all the both Guardians movies as well. He's great I guess he likes working with James Gunn. Because he's also in the Suicide Squad. He's in that, both Guardians. And he's also in Slither, which is also a James Gunn movie. Rook's awesome. Mallrats is great. Great, very, very funny movie. Once again, great cast. It's just, I can't say enough about Mallrats. It's back when malls were a thing. And now things have changed. We're in 2021 now. And malls are dying. Retail dying. So, like, Mallrats are, it's definitely a product of the 90s. There's a lot of the Kevin Smith stuff, product of the 90s. I'm a product of the 90s and 80s. But yeah, I see things nowadays. I'm like, wow, how things have changed. I mean, YouTube, the major things, the entertainment has changed. But yeah, Mallrats. What else is I could give a shout out to for Kevin Smith. I think that's about it with the reboot, the Jay and Silent Bob reboot. It was cool how he did it as well with that. He traveled with Jason Mewes and they're actually at these theaters, and it was a good way to promote it because I think he knew it wasn't that good. And he's got Clerks 3 coming out too, so this is actually good timing. There's been set pictures of Clerks 3, and I'm stoked for that too as well. I hope it's better than the reboot. Anyways, guys, that's my rant and rave about Kevin Smith, my top 10, and I hope you guys all have a good day. All right, and if you can, like and subscribe. I'm just getting started. This channel is about a week old. I've got about 4 or 5 videos up now. Like I said, just doing this for fun, just for a hobby. And if it gets traction, it gets traction. And watch out for my reaction videos. Hopefully I'm going to be doing that sometime this weekend. Anyways, have a good one, guys. Peace.